best Magic player to stream on the D-Hub, for sure. Brandon Coffey, subscribe with Twitch Prime. So now we go woo. Whenever this happens, we get all excited. Subscriptions are awesome.
You have the battle.
So now you go up, Hubby Family Bonding. So now you go up to Collection, because whenever anybody subscribes. This is the content I was waiting for. It's not the content you need. So now you go into. Now you click other products. Which is top left. And then you go to the treasure chest. There. Right click. You open one. We always open a treasure chest. If we're streaming Hubby Family Bondage, we're in a bit of trouble with Twitch. Yes, we are. End the streaming career. We didn't open anything good, Coffee. That's yours. Alright. So now to start the draft, we go over to. You can't close. You go to the play lobby. It's a little slow. You probably can X out. The draft plan. Megan knows exactly what to do. That's what the point is. You go to the play lobby. If you get any notifications or anything like that. Do you want one so that if somebody subscribes you can hear the ba-ding? Okay, so now you go to limited tournaments. Leagues. What's that? Yeah, it was like it scaled out, which made it weird. I have to make the card a little bigger to get it out. We'll figure that out. This is the quality control aspect of the stream. So, what do you mean? Are you talking about like? This is the quality control aspect of the stream. So you go down to Vintage Cube. Okay. Yep. Double click. Then we wait for Moto to think about working. I go for reduce clicking. Okay. So now you go join league. Push down the button. Get 100 play points. We're in it. So we gotta wait for the rest of the other two players to get in. So I'll be playing the draft deck. Because playing would be a little difficult for the boss. But you wanna play? Okay, so here we go. So how it works is you pick one of the cards on top and then it comes down to the bottom. Yeah. Whichever one you want to pick. You can wear your glasses. You can make it larger too. Oh, there's Blair. Blair says hi, Meg. You can do whichever one you want. I'm not going to give you any pointers. You got it. Okay. Because that's colorless. This is stressful.
This is really stressful.
Okay, give it a double click. Okay. Now you should read Pestermite. It does something cool. Okay. So when Pestermite comes into play, it taps or untaps something. That's part of the cube draft. There's like 700 cards you can pick from. They don't always all show up. Which one are you liking? What are you feeling?
If you want to take Phantasmal Image, you can do it. The chat's also giving you advice.
Can they see all the questions?
Yes, they can see. This is what the chat says. Good lady on there. Somebody either followed, subscribed, or don't. Look at that. Look at the chat. The twin combo, babe. You going for it? It's a good card.
I really assume it's not the twin combo.
That is not the twin combo. Usually the ugliest card is like the strongest. Jasper doesn't not like you. He just doesn't like your selection.
That's fine. That's not, that's a different card.
If you want to grab it, you can. You can grab whichever one you want.
There's code.
They're speaking the names. Like, Ifling Cloudscape, Gurmag Angler, Gush, Nature's Claim. I find it funny that you're doing a cube draft for the first time. You're saying to people in the chat don't know what they're talking about. You have 10 seconds.
No, I didn't say they didn't know. I'm saying I don't know what they're talking about.
Oh, okay. All right, we're doing it. You can get go for the throw. That's like what happens when I don't clean. You What are you thinking?
That's a 2-1-0-0.
The Phantasmal Image is a 0-0. Yeah, I asked if you wanted to do a practice last night. We are tribal fairies at the moment, Megan.
How do you know which
one's a fairy? So you see how it says fairy rogue, fairy wizard. Click on double click on Glenn and Audrey. Hold the two pictures, hold both of them down. Fairy? Oh, we should change the title. Which we'll do after she makes this pick. Okay, go over here. You're right there. Yep, go up there. And just write, just go wife draft or something like that. Whatever you think would best. That's pretty great. Yep, and go down to update. You don't have to do that, it's already live. All right, and we got 20 seconds left for that.
Oh, okay.
Crater Dome, you're right. Give 4 seconds.
Oh my God, can't handle this.
It gets slower. It gets faster the lesser cards you get. It is a good one. And white. This is Abzan Traverse. It's a lot different than I remember. MTG Bot's my homeboy. It's like my guy that does all my plugs and stuff. Really?
Yeah.
God, that's very well. 14 seconds. It gets quicker the less cards you get in the pack. They got a type pass in.
I know, but nobody's telling me what to choose.
We gotta load some golem. We ran out of time. This draft. What does that mean? I think he's just jealous that you're better at it. Oh, the Linvala. Linvala is the name of this card that you took last time. All right, we got a plan. Yes, because it was the only one left in the pack. Now we get more time, because we're going into the next pack. Look at all this, you know, you have to pick from. There's a good one. There's a good one. Don't even look at the chat. You can figure it out. 100% jealous.
Not see
this is the guy that dumped it. GC Shadow Smiles 42.
Nothing's funny.
What do you mean?
Just tell me.
Oh, there's a good one. You have 30 seconds. You can look at the chat as well. That was a good one. That was a really good one. No, we didn't end up taking the Traverse King Arthreos. We were playing Abzan Traverse for a little while, but then it was time for GC Shadow Miles. It's a really good pad. Mm-hmm. Well, one of them makes white and blue. One of them makes red and blue. That's the chat. That was the last one. We had a discrepancy. It was a really good pack, so we might get something back out of it because it goes around the table. There's a virtual table we're playing at. The packs go like this. Counterspell is like somebody tries to do something and you say no. Bitch, please.
Got it.
Okay. All right. One of these cards is blue. Blue is the best color. Solid. Not even thinking twice.
I feel like that's supposed to be the foil.
What's that? Oh, that's because you clicked on it. Click on another one. And then it gets. You can't believe you have to pick. Ooh, babe.
Diamond?
Diamond. Which diamond? We don't know. He's a little cheeky. In his statements. Well, the next pack's out of your babe. Taking the rock. It's cold outside. So now look at our colors that we have and kind of coordinate it with the cards.
Okay.
Yeah, this is like our wedding all over again. This draft is like our wedding, you know? Nautilus for saying Manatide in all caps. No, I'm excited. Now, check them all out. Ankle shaker.
Do you need any lands?
So you get to add your lands.
Oh, I have
but there are some good lands in the like it is slightly. You're like my recruiter of the guard.
Oh my god.
You should read it and then you can see that. That's what you read. We need the wedding planners. You're doing great. This is a pretty good deck. It's a combo. Oh. Why don't you scroll up in the chat? Go over to the chat. You wanna go scroll up? Add quote. Oh, it's a moderator thing. Now you're laughing. That's Nathan's favorite land because Nathan's a scrub.
Oh.
She's on top of it. She's on top of it, Farby. She knows. She knows.
There's obviously a delay.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a delay. And why did you choose Bring to Light? What made you choose that?
It was the first one in the line.
Look at this. We got ourselves a little heater going on. This is a good one. 78 viewers. Glad you're all tuning in to watch the greatest draft of all time. Farby's happy. Well, that's good that Farby's happy. Yep. Last pack. Double click on it to read it. You're just like not about that, right?
Yeah,
that's
good.
Convert the columns. Like 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so it's like 5 up here. 4, 3, 2. It's like 1 in a blue equals 2. 2 in a white equals 3. It's what it costs to play. Ponderosa. Blue. This is a pretty good pack. Keep drafting like this and you'll be cute for the PT in no time. Megan, the Pro Tour needs you. You're my angel. That is a good one. It could be the one that I'm talking about. That's from the last pack.
Oh.
Their chat's just a tad behind. I wish that the artists were showing that better. But, you know, Magic Online is a quality. Dylan Hovey with the smooth MTG pickup lines. So you're not my Moldrifter?
No, I love that.
But Moldrifter is a good card. You are a good card. What if Moldrifter is?
I'm ugly too.
You're not ugly. No. Not even before you get coffee in the morning. You're not even ugly.
Yeah,
ew. All right. Defensible. It was a rock. That's the plan. We take rocks.
That wasn't a rock,
was it? It's a signet. It's one that's highlighted. She draws you cards and dies.
Sorry.
That was that card dies, yeah. Yes, we can thirst for knowledge. Which if you discard... We get rocks. What is that, like a fat joke or something? What does that mean? What does upheaval mean? How would upheaval be?
Oh my god.
I'm so confused. What does that mean? Oh, you said that I just fucked it up?
Yeah, you just come in.
I just professionally fucked it up?
Yeah.
It's kind of a cool sound. Coffee's liking it. He's liking it. Perfect here. That's like two signets. For sure.
What?
You have two signets, we're good. We have people, we get chat approved, upheaval is great. You're a time of reinforcement for me. We should just make that bad pickup jokes throughout this entire draft. You double click to see it. You know, you just hold them. Hold both She is pretty cool.
But that's not a card.
It's a negative. What do you think? Humans are cool. You know, they both do their thing. Can we get some epic sax? No, this is a non-epic sax man channel. You do. They pick for 40 grand.
Huh.
Wow. You have just, like, leveled up. That's how you, that's like how drafting works.
That's tough.
Are you saying Magic's easy? So now, so chat, does Megan build the deck or do I build the deck?
Wait, I don't know how to build a deck.
Or should. We'll get the Sanctum back to smash the snake. I wish it were more of a dumpster fire, to be honest. Like, they're saying the deck's actually, you actually have good cards. Which they wish that it sucked, because it would be more funny. So who builds it?
You
build it. Okay. So you want to switch out? Do I need to get Megan's sign of, like, snapshot of approval before we play it, or how does this work?
I mean, if they want a dumpster fire, they could build it.
Yeah, dude, just build it.
How?
So
give me some guy, but, like, how many of these cards?
So it's up here. This is usually how it works.
Do I have a time limit?
No. You can take your time. 40 cards, 17 lands, and 23 spells. So how you get rid of them is you double click them. So it's the first
thing. How many do you... Oh, this is what you need.
That's what we have.
What can you play with?
So I usually like playing with 17 lands. Okay. We have 5 so far. We can add them up here, the basic lands. But in order for us to do that, we have to figure out what we're doing down here first. The Archmage is giving some serious advice here.
Yeah, like all these black cards are
really different. Yep. Archmage. 15, 5, 2, 1.
That's the same page, Archmage.
Never mind.
But that has one blue.
But it has double black, so it's not going to be hard to cast. Mud skips, so we should make the last caster. That's the card you just got rid of. we're getting closer so far. Like we've got 30, we have so far 37, and we have to get down to like 24. So let's start by getting rid of all the black cards. There's a couple black cards down there. Do you want to make them bigger?
I can
see. So you just go here and drag it out. That means that you can cast them at anything. It doesn't matter. So, do you want to group our creatures separately? Do you want to have the creatures separated? What do you think?
Yes.
Okay, so go right click.
From what?
Just right click. Group creatures separately. So now we have all our spells on the bottom. We have all our creatures on top. Because he's the only one drop creature here. Yeah. No, that one's good. That's a big one. That's our hammer. That's our winner. So we got to cut 10. We have to cut 9 cards. So if you want to read them, you can click both of them and it makes it larger. Considering this is your first game of Magic, first draft, the fact you're already starting to think makes sense. I think you're a prodigy. Like, the problem with Epic Sax Man Coffee is that I can't upload it to YouTube because of the copyright. Probably should get rid of this one because it makes green, right? We got rid of all the like, do the whole. See how it makes green? We got rid of the green. Now these don't count towards the cards we have to cut because we have to add lands, and these are like lands. And these cost 0, so you actually can move both of these over to here.
Do I?
So what cards do you think? What cards do you think are the coolest? What cards do you definitely want to keep?
Good.
We get some advice from chat. We probably should cut some 3 and 4 casting cards from our deck.
Up here?
Well, anyway, because the 3s go down right through here, the 4s go down right through here, the 5s. Because they cost 3. Like, right, 1 equals 3. We have a vote from our donator. You're doing good. You're doing good. Now go right click. Just right click and then sort by converted. And then move it back over. We're getting some more help from the chat. That timing is good. Mudkip is Kylie. Timing disc should be good. It's like the beginning. Like there's timely reinforcements or never mind his disc. Unless you like him. Unless you like him. If you like him, you can just tell them whatever. When you show up, you help. That's what a recruiter. You're my recruiter today. Wow. Archmage has recruited us. We're going with Archmage. No one cares. No one cares what player says. So we're currently at 16. We have to cut 6 more cards.
Oh my god, why don't you draw too many of them?
Remember we talked about the disc? Alright, 5 more. Here we go. Do not. We're having a lot of recruiter arguments in the chat here. So what cards do you think are the coolest? What do you feel?
I think cool.
We're not about winning here. We're about having fun. Ancient Tumex too. I do love them. We got some. We got some advice there from the chat. Okay. I think you're getting outvoted on the Winter Orb party. Winter Orb's just too. It's too Hygge. I'm gonna teach the chat about Hygge. Do you guys know about Hygge?
I think I just have something.
You know who plays Scrubland? Scrubs. So you're going to leave the Scrubland in there to pick on me? Or?
Is that Nathan?
No. I don't think Nathan's watching. Yeah. But we'll be able to send it to the...
Okay, how many more?
That's 28. We need to cut 4.
I just cut like 5.
Well, lands don't count. Enters battlefield, draws 2 cards. There's the mega right there. That's the creature. That's a part of our tribal fairies. You're my angel. Getting some help. Someone says Signet. Oh, I think you're right about that one. Went a little too easy with that. Go with the Vryn Wigmere. So we have 27, so we need to make 3 cuts. If you would like to cut the Signet, I would keep the Signet. I think the Signet. Yeah, our diamond in the Signet is really good. We could just go with this man if this is what you want to do.
Oh, I didn't know that was an option.
It is an option. We can play whatever. We can play 13 lands on the deck if you want to.
Man, people really don't like that. I think
whatever. 26. 3 more.
How are we good?
You can do it. You can be good if you want.
Let's go. Let's buy it.
Right. So now we go to add basic lands. And it adds them. So we say okay. Yep. Now we go right click. Sort. Buy from your mana pool. All right. So we got 11, 14. We have 15 lands. We're good. We're good. Let's make it happen.
Okay.
Hit the play, babe.
Play.
You're piloting? You're not?
Can you want me to leave?
Yeah.
I don't know how to play.
Well, there's no time like the present, right? There's no more coffee left. Do you want me to go make you some more coffee? Is that what that helped me?
No.
That helped the play? Okay. Oh, we found a person. Thanks. Nice job, Meg.
Fun.
We can always sideboard in more lands. You are off the hook, unless you'd like to stay and watch your creation. Okay. So it was a sweater that I got We did an ugly Christmas swap at our family, so we got this one.
And then I got, because during my brother's best man speech, he says that he's been on Team Meg for a while.
Barbie, we might need 3 more lands, but this is what Megan wants. We can always sideboard our lands in. Let me go through here. RW Pointer, thank you very much for the follow. I appreciate that. Coffee with the subscription, and TTEN to Tenor. Tenor, if you're still in the chat, thank you very much. Yeah, it's a tie. So, we're gonna Logan. And we got 2 lands, we're gonna keep this thing. Probably at the bottom of Shackles. It's awesome. Get rid of the donation bar, sure. We drew a land. We can't lose. Well, we would like to be able to cast a Mirror Angel. A Mirror, there are land count, and a Mirror Angel is kind of a nombo. Oh, don't play a Signet. Oh, a Sylvan Library, that's going to be pretty hard to do. God, if we ever get to Elish Norn or Mirror Crusader, we're golden. Megan played a little bit when I was in high school, but she hasn't played since we were in high school. You played like 4 or 5. That's totally a little bit. So we're gonna land this Mirror Crusader and hope it wins. And then we're gonna Phantasmal Image the Mirror and Crusader next turn. High school, gosh, high school was 6 years ago? Draws 2 cards with Sylvan. Oh no, that's just library doing library things. God, we might do it. We might get it. Too bad we can't play Celestia Signet unless we draw. We can't play Signet and Thirst for Knowledge unless we draw land. Oh, that's sad. Wait, is this a Nombo? If they, yeah, that's a pretty serious one. Well, that's a pretty serious Nombo. Because they just Gideon and kill it. All right, Pestermite is sweet, but I don't think we necessarily want to play Pestermite at this point. So let's go find a land. Discard an artifact. Now we have to play a Mirror Angel next turn. It was both a little cheeky. Part of the appeal. Top. So now we can play Angel and can we play Angel and Signet and make a thing now? So I think our game plan here is we're gonna play this Emiria Angel, copy the Emiria Angel, and then eventually cast Elish Norn. I think that's the game plan. Unless my opponent plays something big ugly. Oh, that's big ugly. Tap my Emiria Crusader. God, what a dream. Now I think I kind of want to like Pestermite just to kind of harass my opponent a little more at the end of the turn. Exactly. Hey, she took the Pestermite. She tried. Okay, so what are we doing? We should just play the Emiria even though we don't have a land drop. How does this work? You play Pestermite and Signet. Are we playing this Academy Ruins? Can I go Signet now? Yeah, I guess we just go Pestermite, Boom Boom here. I can go Pestermite and Signet, or I can play the Amira Ranger. I guess I don't have any reason to play the Academy, and this just is the Academy but better, because it makes mana. So let's go here. Discard this. Then cast this. And then end of turn, we'll Pestermite something. Ruins can return the Revoker. Yes. But I don't think we're about that yet. We can fire out this Colonnade next turn if our opponent doesn't Tanya it. 58 viewers, thanks everybody for showing up and hanging out for our Sweet Cube draft today. Megan appreciates it. And she had a good time. I can tell. She liked it. She was a fan. Tap this down, okay? I can Pestermite, yes. Umezawa's Jet is going to be pretty good against us. Okay. So if they go to equip this, I'm going to try to just tap this down. Jidon and Gideon is, like, definitely not really great for the home team. Tap-tap-tap-aroo. So how do we... What is your momentary shadow list? What is my momentary shadow list? What do you mean there, cuz? I'm like, what I'm playing right now? So here's the question. Do we have to untap... The problem is if we untap this Colonnade to get in, we don't even kill the Gideon next turn. But then... No, we're good, because the Crusader is going to finish off the Gideon. We're in good shape. We're in good shape here. This is odd. This is a very odd brainstorm. Yeah. It's a pretty odd odd time to brainstorm. Probably means that they're pretty counterspell light. Because they had a counterspell. I guess they didn't really have the mana. I would like to use Pestermite's ability, yes. Alright, so we get the good man off the field. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Not quite. So now, how does this work? Tap target permanent. That's sad. So now we just get in here. We get the Gideon off the battlefield. Tap Gideon to the trial so we just don't get Umezawa's Jitted out of this game. Yeah, I agree, Archmage. How sick is it gonna be if we hit the land, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, if we hit the land for Elishnorn next turn? If our opponent Wrath Tamios us, then like such is life. But if we get to manatize something this turn, how sweet that would be. There are a few things that I like more in Magic than force spiking a card. Treachery. That's sad. So I guess I should force spike this so that they can't equip Umezawa's Jitte to it. No, because that doesn't matter, because these lands untap. That blows. Yeah. Yeah, because they're going to untap these lands anyways. That sucks. It's not your fault. I would probably get banned from Nightbot if we get to hit something. Nightbot just doesn't like you. Maybe they'll untap my land. Yeah, I mean, they get a jet in. They get a jet activation, which isn't good for the home team. What is nice, if we get Elish Norn in, then they can't. They do get a jet, but it doesn't do anything. So we just need... Oh, man. There's the mana tie. So we are no longer getting a jet, getting this in. Yes. I don't think they're going to be able to haste their own Zalo's jet in. What sucks is that we can't kill this thing now because of whatever it is. What is this? At least we can get a shot in at Tamio if and like knock it down a little bit. What I meant is their Link in the Shadow is to play in Modern. Oh, that's sad. There is, give me 1 second. So, I guess I go Phantasmal Image, the Emyria Angel. Phantasmal Image is my Pestermite, tap the Emyria Angel, get in, and then play Mirren Crusader. Yeah, you can look up. Yes. Attack Tamio. Let's get this. Guy in play. Okay, let me see if I can find. Let me go over this. I'll find my Death Shadow. Sweetness. I think I should go. Hang on. Wait. I forgot what the plug is. Yeah, this jet's gonna like. This jet's really gonna mess us up. I forgot what that plug was. That's too many plugs. I have to get rid of some of my plugs. Oh, nice. What was that? What if Sun Titan gets back Gideon? I guess we just do Sun Titan by itself and then get a Planeswalker back. Let's go here. You can check that out there for what we're currently doing. So if our opponent doesn't have, we can get rid of, if we draw land, unless our opponent, did our opponent Tamio or something? So land, one time. That's not terrible. Like they're just going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They can't move the jet and cast Sun Titan next turn unless they get back Flooded Strand. Alternatively, I could just like, but then they're gonna get the Emyria Angel back. I think every time Sower isn't great though, yeah, because they can just, yeah. So like, it's not super great, but I think our best play is to, we can get this off the field, make it so they can't, they have to Sun Titan back a land, they can't Sun Titan back to Gideon and move the jet. Yeah, I think we're going to take this thing back. just kind of harass their mana a little bit. Oh, I need to do more blue mana. Just give me back my Emyria Angel, dude. I could take the Sun Titan. The problem is the Sun Titan just, like, messes me up. But if we take the Sun Titan, then he gets in a shot with the Jit, and then they just kill the Sower with the Jit. I'll plow. All right, we're good. We're going to go to game two. Yeah, exactly, Archmage. Let's get our game two action on. Oh, Moto's losing their mind. It's mine. All right, let's look. So we're gonna board in more lands. Is that our game here? The disc seems pretty good against planeswalker.deck. So I think we want this. I think we wanna cut this. Probably cut this. Riffling Cavs go through fine. Does this not kill Planeswalkers? God, that's dumb. I could just add two lands. Go like this. Because the Wingmare is not that good, right? You're just going like, you're just turning into a complete stacked deck. I'm going to go with this as a good. Yeah, it was just Planeswalkers. So you just want to turn into a stack. So I guess that makes sense. I mean, it's like a Planeswalker world. Maybe the Sower's not good because of Umezawa's Jitte. Then we probably just like add two lands. Yeah, let's try this. Let's try this out. The Winter Orb seems too cute. Because like I want to cast 5 drops as well. Their 5 drops are better than my 5 drops, but I still want to like get up there eventually. Heater. We have lands. Well, Elish Norn is just sweet, right? I mean, Elish Norn is awesome when it comes to our Mirror Angel plan. But we get like a pretty, I want to keep this hand because we get our mana online and we're going to get to Moldrifter quickly. Well, anything's a good way to get treachery, right, Archmage? Like, you know, I am a creature deck. Therefore, I am weak to treachery. Do we want to Force Spike a Sylvan Library? Well, Force Spike and Gideon. Dude, what is Nightbot doing? Some of this, some of the music's great, but some of the music just sucks. From like the non-copyrighted stuff. I'm probably gonna see, once I get monetized, I'm gonna see like what the revenue is. Recruit the Guard Suite. See what the revenue is from YouTube. And if it's not great, then I'll probably just start playing like music on my own stream that I wanna do. Come on, give me some of the Force Spike, man. You monster. What a monster. That Vidalkin Shackles actually isn't super great. Play around the Force Spike perfectly. Okay. So we can't really play this. Probably have to go just get a revoker. Because it just kind of throws off our whole game plan if this doesn't resolve. Yeah, I agree. Postscript. Yeah, we know how this works. Where are your Phyrexian Revoker? God, if he four spikes me, I'm gonna lose it. That was the first time that I was ever doing cube leagues. What are we gonna do? The Dolphin. First time I was ever doing a cube league, I had like this really sweet ramp deck, and when I was playing, my opponent, I played like right into a daze because I drafted daze and it just lost me. I really wanted to do another cube deck. Yep, that's what cube does. But I just lost it because I played like, had my opponent completely beat, and then I just played into a daze that I had drafted, and I was just like, this is terrible. So next turn we can play Mirran Crusader and then hold up Thirst for Knowledge. And four spike. And then we're gonna be able to probably play Elish Norn. We have 5, 6. Then we find a land, we can Elish Norn, which is gonna be sweet. Okay. Library ain't gonna save you now, man. Unless they treachery me. And then I'm probably gonna die. It's not gonna be good. It would be kinda sweet if we drew a sword. Sword plus Mirran Crusader combo. So hopefully my opponent doesn't have like Plow Steel. That'd be pretty bad. And then we can play Elish Norn next turn, which Elish Norn puts a hurt in this. 8, 12, 13. So if my opponent gets aggressive off of this Sylvan Library, Elish Norn can kill him. God, they played around Force Spike again? That's a little frustrating. But like, what are you gonna do? They're just like perfectly played around four spike in each game, in each, like the two times they could have played into it. Oh, that's frustrating. But that's what you can do. Like, you know, you can stream snipe. They put a card on top, and they kept the card. At least we're gonna be able to draw a bunch of cards with this Thirst. And like, the Elish Norn's gonna kind of fix our problem here as long as we get to land it. All right, so maybe they're not stream cycling because let's say like a Force. Probably just gonna discard two cards because I want to keep this Revoker for the later game. We only have 3 islands, so maybe I do just want to discard an artifact. Nah, we'll be like adults here. I'll get rid of this and this. We're not forced by them even. That's a pretty good draw. So if we get to untap here, we're in good shape. A because my opponent dazes me. We are conceding to a daze. Alright. Okay. So we have a chance. Now we just need to untap, and we're going to be able to counterspell. Well, they can't. They need two lands, right? Gain control of target with power less than it. So they need two islands. But we're going to be able to revoker the shackles, unless they plow this thing, which looks like what's going to happen. That's sad. Don't play like a Jace. They have their own Amir Angel. That's probably going to be us. Why didn't they get an island? Oh, you can't get an island off where you put hills. That's going to get us good, most likely. So I just, like, bounce this and attack. And then play the Revoker. So let's go Revoker. We'll name Shackles. Search the Dalkin Shackles. And then, yeah, we're gonna get aggressive. There's not a lot of great stuff from here to get, but like we're definitely behind, but at least we can bounce this and then get in for some damage. Because our opponent is not at a very high life total. And it's gonna take, so they're gonna take at least one and they lose their board presence. Oh no, never mind, this is no haste. Bounce our, oh, that would have been good. That would have been very good. I missed that. Yep. Nope, that would have been very good. Because we find Sower. Nope, you were right. That was a punt on my part. I just completely forgot about that. I'll send that one out there for you guys. Something that I struggle at, and like I love Q, but I'm not super great at it, is I miss those little interactions until I know how a deck works. And then when I'm really good with a deck, yeah. Oh, there's a jet. And we didn't even have the, ugh. Then bing bing. Yep. Umezawa Jitte is like, I guess I'll just block it. Umezawa Jitte is like really bad in cube, but like in these powered cubes, but man, when it's good. Like for those exceptions, it's just like, damn. Just completely wrecks. I'm gonna eat this. And they can shackles this. We probably don't have a draw yet. All right. We will concede. Oh, yeah, well, that makes sense. The old Regin lose, yeah. But, like, in Powered Cube, like, Jit's not what it's worth. But not what it's about. This guy's got 25 trophies. Let me check this. KLB's got 18. Yeah, but that's not necessarily what it's about, right? Like, what these decks are about anymore. Or like, I think it's amazing in Legacy Cube. In Legacy Cube, it's unreal. I would like to play first. Yeah, man, we'll keep this. We'll just win over our opponent, and hopefully Vidalcan Shackles them out of the game. Yeah. Exactly. Jit's the best fair thing you can do in these cubes, and most of the time they're not about fair things, like when there's like mana rocks and stuff. Yeah, exactly. So there's a number of decks where Jit is amazing against, and there's a number of decks where it's very bad. Well, they're fair decks that are made unfair by power. And I'm just saying, like, in a Black Lotus game, Jit doesn't matter. Or, like, a Mox... or, like, a Mox Signet game, that doesn't matter. I'm just saying, like, the best fair decks are super-powered fair decks, which makes them unfair. You know? Over God knows what. I turned one Jace somebody a couple days ago, and that was sweet. Hey, thanks, Camzo. I put a lot of effort into that. I'm not a super great writer, but... Yes. Yes, but, like, a play like that, but I'm just saying, like, because of how Cube works... and how these cube decks are, is like, if somebody goes like land, Mox, Signet, then you're gonna lose that game. And like, and Jinte is not gonna save you there. You know? Cause like you can strip their resources, but they're just playing 7 mana cards on turn like 4. Yeah. There's definitely an argument. Yes, and that's why I like playing it right now. I think there's a lot of dumb combo decks in Modern that just don't play removal. We lost the first round. It was tight. Yeah, we lost to an Umezawa Jinte. We're gonna play your winter card here on one though. On two, I mean. Does anybody in the chat know what Huga is? Have we figured that out yet? Because that's how Megan drafted. I would not cut a Traverse from Death Shadow. Right? Well, if we're missing land drops, it's not that bad with Winter Orb, right? Megan had this figured out. My opponent recalls? Okay. No. It's H-Y-G-G-E. Oh, we have Dak. Well, good night. We're getting Dak'd. Alright, we're going to untap our land at least and name Dak. And they just ditched a push, which is sweet. Search. Dak Faden. The best planeswalker. I think Dak's the best planeswalker in the cube. Yeah, some planes would be sweet. If we could rip like 5 planes in a row, I'd be happy about it. The fact that our opponent's got a Lotus Bloom coming is not good for the home team. Question is, should I be like an adult and attack this deck? Because like, do I actually think that this is going to survive much longer? I think I'm still going to try to kill that, because I'm pretty sure that like against the Fatal Push Ancestral Recall deck that they're going to find a way to get this Revoker off key. Well, Ashiok's really good too. Don't kill me, man. Oh, now we're dead. Babe, we're in trouble. We're getting beat up. It's okay. Both teams had fun. Both teams are having fun. We're good. We'll side into some more lands. I like your analysis, Archmage. So after we finish this cube draft, I'm going to finish my Abzan Traverse League, and then we're going to call it a night, because I need to clean up the house, get ready for our plans we have this evening. Let's get rid of this. I'll get rid of this. Let's add two lands. Yeah. First. Oh, effects. I thought you said all four. Aren't you playing a cube? We will keep this. Hopefully we get to counterspell something on two. I thought you were talking about like Ixalan draft. You got four Kite Cell Freebooters there. If we draw a white source, then we're in decent shape, because we'll be able to play like our Vryn Wigmare. I'm looking to counterspell a Dak here. That would be the dream. The Ancient Tomb kind of offsets our issues here, our man issues. So we're just going to play this island this turn, counterspell something, and my opponent can't play a 3-mana planeswalker under Vryn Wigmare. So I wonder if I just play this or I hold up counterspell. I think I play this, because the only removal we saw was like Fatal Push, and he's going to have to like go for the throw into Red Source Dak, which appears like what's going to happen. Oh, it is Ancestral, that's not bad. Whatever. It is kind of rough when your opponent recalls in both games. We are getting mollywopped on. I have to remember my counterspell costs 3. I don't want to zone out there. Just play the land, okay? Alright. I guess we just like Lodestone Golem it up. We bring the taxes. Like maybe we're doing it. It's like, I have so many cards to play, but I can't play them. Like, that's what you get, man. All of your spells, your deck costs 5. They don't have anything. Don't you speak about that. We always play this stream. We play like our opponent has nothing. Every time. Now, if we draw a basic, we actually don't even need to like do anything. We can just sit behind this and just seven them every turn. Alright, well now we just two then. Ooh. This Winter Orb is sweet. Sadly, Dak is reasonable at five. Well, I don't think my opponent's gonna get to cast Dak this game. Doesn't it? Non-creature spells. Oh, it doesn't work like that. Okay. So now everything that my opponent does costs three. And we're not blocking. We're just gonna peck him for two in the air. We're gonna untap. Probably just untap a... all right, we'll do this. I don't really want to play this, right? Because this makes it so... Because this costs two. Then I don't have counterspell up. Yeah, we're going to wait and then cast that next turn. I want to be able to play around counterspell. Yeah, this Winter Orb is amazing. It's pretty awesome. We drew all three of our taxing elements. That's a combo. That right there, that is a combo deck, Archmage. I'm just gonna peck at you, dude. Now, can I play my... Because, well, my counterspell costs one, two, three. My counterspell costs five at the moment. So, three, four. Yeah, so we're just gonna continue just sitting behind this counterspell. That is a combo deck. I don't know how my opponent's gonna cast something relevant. And, Maze of Ith is annoying. So now I need to figure out a way how to sneak a creature into play. One, two. Suspend. Suspend doesn't do anything, right? So let me just. Back in with this. Wow, are you maze? No, he's on maze. Wow, he's been maze, okay. We still have counterspell up. Surprised my opponent was just click through and not maze. I think I would rather suspend the neuter. Because when that comes down, I can just bounce the Lodestone Golem, or their Lodestone Golem, and I can just attack and kill him, right? Yeah, we're gonna let this go. We're not gonna counterspell anything. And then we can even, like, fire up this Colonnade. Also, when this sucker comes off suspend. Megan, we're doing it. We're winning. Me too. What is this? What do you got, opponent? You're like, I can't do enough. Because every single non-artifact creature spell got six. Yeah, opponent's not going to do anything. Yeah. Blocking Blister for one. I think we counterspell this. Because I just want to keep the stacks going. Because it's basically like, in some ways, this just buys us a turn. Because, because it just taps them down more. This one, tap this one. Not maze of a thing, okay. My opponent not understand how this works, like. I said they just don't get how maze of it works, probably. Am I gonna have to cast? I'm gonna have to pay for this. Like, pay two to have this come in. Right? So I can actually thirst it for. No, I can't even thirst for knowledge. Oh, yeah, because it can only. Well, it can just untap it every turn, I guess. Yeah. So I wonder if I. I wonder if I bounce the Maze of Ith. Probably what I do. Did you just get balanced? Or did you balance somebody else? I should have Garfield. Hammer by Jones, I like the name. My Elf will skip. That's rude. So I probably just bounce. Maybe I just bounce the Baleful Strix to get in. With my, to get in with my Cloudscape. Now I have to cast two for this, right? Okay. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna bounce the Strix and then get in with for four. Oh, Mana Tide might be sweet. Because Force Spike's the real deal. Right now. And now that we have three flying blockers. Oh yeah, we're gonna get the Mana Tide this. Oh no, we're not. Not anymore. Oh, Spike does cost four. You're right. You can't count. Okay. Opponent might crawl back into this. Does that let me get colonnade going? One, two, three, four. Yeah, that means colonnade, so he goes block. Block colonnade, take four. I'll just get into the team in here. Yes, sir. Babe, we won our first game. Alright. I don't think we changed very much. We just kind of keep it as is. Yeah, whatever. We're going to keep it. We're going to keep it, and then we're gonna tax him out of the game. And I said to cut orb. Shows what you know, Blair. Shows what you know. You call yourself an educator of young people, Blair. You're telling them, you educate your young people to cut Winter Orb too? I kind of just want to keep this. And then just Winter Orb to buy me time. Like, four spike something, play Orb. I think that's our plan. Like, I do totally understand how this is not super great, but I just kind of want to, like, four spike and Ancestral. Hopefully. My opponent's lucky enough to have four Ancestrals, or Ancestral in game on turn two of all three games. So, yeah, we're going to finish this cube, finish up my league of Abzan Traverse, and then jump, then call it for the day. If I had to earn my keeps, I'd be in trouble. I appreciate the honesty. Ooh, this recruiter can go get Phyrexian Metamorph. No, we didn't have the Metamorph, our opponent did. Come on, dude, cast something. Because that goes and gets Ancestral, they pay for it. We untap Winter Orb, which makes this game a lot harder for our opponent. Opponent has the out of just drawing like a million, cards and making all their land drops. So we might not win this game. Yeah. So there's the Ancestral. There's their land drop. Untap this. Well, we have a plan. We can play Crusader next turn. You just teach people how to mill, Blair. You'd be all set. Don't deck me. We're just going to jam this Mirror Crusader. There's our blue mana, so we can ponder. Orcs' Colonnade was an island. Destroy target artifact, discard card. I guess I just discard Counterspell? Might be in trouble now. We have landed, like, a really good card. And if we draw another land, then we can play Archmage and have a blue mana up. That I can do if there was no Emerald Cool, it would be a winner. That's so funny that everybody from that fun draft or that knew that you were coming. Oh, Mizzen Mortars, it sucks. They knew you were coming, so they Alright, Mox Diamond isn't doing it. I guess I will recruiter first. They knew you were coming, so they put like an Blair, what's his name, put an Emerald Cool in the sideboard. Let's ponder. I think I want all of these. And I want to play the. I want to draw the island, discard the planes. So we're gonna put this. 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 No. And we're gonna play Mox Diamond. Then ditch the planes. So our game plan is Glenelinda Archmage plus Sword of Fire Knights, or Sword of whichever one she drafted. Jace the Mind Sculptor, you don't say. Well, we'll probably be colonnading that next turn. Hopefully, if he doesn't kill, unless he Fate Seals me, which he could Fate Seal me. That's a good play. We're gonna put a land that we saw on the bottom, which means we're gonna draw the equipment. And we're gonna sneak in. We put a land on top, which was the hard part there, and he saw that. So now we're gonna go. We draw the sword. So now we go like this. Play the Archmage. Archmage isn't bad, especially if we draw a land next turn. We can play sword, equipped and crack, and we can hit our opponent because this is red and blue. So we probably just kill the Jace, but we can't kill the Jace. So we'll probably just hit the opponent. He can just bounce it now if he wants to, but I don't know if he will. Like, he might just be like, I'm going to slog through this. That probably cooks us. And then he bounced it. Opponent's playing well. We might give this cube draft the drop after this one. This didn't necessarily turn out exactly like I, anticipated. I might just get back to the traverse deck. I'm just gonna like plus. Yeah, we're dead. All right, we are gonna jump back into the other. We're gonna finish up our league, and then I'm gonna call it for the day. So let's go. Hit this again, then we'll go back into some constructed.